Crusader Kings 2. This is the Wolf's Revenge with Lord Paramount Eddard of the North, the recently freed captive of King's Landing. We discover the truth about King Joffrey, the false king, the false boy that sits on the Iron Throne. He is not a true-born issue of Robert Baratheon. With the true king dead and the Lannisters attempting to usurp the throne, Eddard Stark has managed to escape back to the north, and now he rallies his support. He's apparently also still getting justice. I don't know if that's actually going to affect what we're doing. I sincerely hope not. But King Joffrey could very well attempt to arrest us again, but I don't think he will, because we are allied currently with the Riverlands and will blow us up into war. And we have a lot of betrothals and things like that going on. If we can make people like us more, we could essentially get most of Westeros into another rebellion against the Iron Throne and the false king boy, the false boy king sitting on the Iron Throne. First things first, we have to start a faction. We can see there's already a few factions. We got Deposed King Joffrey, led by Lord of Rosby. We got Lord Crown Authority being led by Balon, which is kind of silly. Then Lord Paramount Hoster's there as well. We're going to start a faction for Lord Stannis of the Iron Throne. And we will put Stannis. Stannis will be on the throne because he has the rightful claim. Let's see, Stannis doesn't even really like us, but we're busy trying to sway Mace Tyrell. He's the most important person to, to get on our side. We've married his daughter, Marjorie Tyrell, to Robb Stark, a fantastic couple. And they will bring the North and the Reach together. I mean, in all honesty, if we can get the North and the Riverlands and the Reach on our side, that could be enough to destroy the Lannisters for good. For good. Let's see, the Stormlands are led by Renly. Ah, and we're also got Renly. Yes, we have spread our wings. We have married our children off to many different corners of Westeros, and we have the potential for many alliances, but we must be quick about it. We must be quick. We cannot dither for long. Let's see, can we change? I really wish I had switched. I had waited on choosing my focus and had picked carousing, because that would have been way better for bringing together the Lords of the Realm. Unfortunately, we're stuck with this for the next 5 years. It's kind of shit. We have one child left, Lord Rickon. We did not find a suitable person for him. So I think what somebody suggested was to marry Rickon to Dany. See if we can do that. But first we have to find her. Where would she be? Would she be a Targaryen? Ah, there she is. Aemon. Ah, he's on the wall. Targo, who is, oh, he's not a Targaryen. His name is just Targ. Yes, there is Daenerys. She is 15. Let's see, Viserys is dead. Yes, she is here. Where is she? She is Educator Sir Manfrey Martell in an unknown location. So she is alive, but she is widowed. She will false visions. Curious. We will add her to a character of interest. She is currently widowed. We cannot marry her. Maybe we can in the future. She's got claims on the Iron Throne, so we could put her on the Iron Throne. But I think it would be better to have Stannis there. Stannis would be better to have there. So let's go ahead and start the timer. Can we... Let's see. Oh, we can do nothing with our council. We've assigned jobs to everybody, so we'll have to wait. Some people talked about changing my regent. I rather like Howland Reed as the regent. The only one person I would change it to is Catelyn Stark. Catelyn Tully, I mean. All right, let's fill out the rest of our commanders here. Get the best of the best. Actually, Rob. We also gave Rob Mokaelin, so he's a lord in his own right. We'll have you be one of our commanders. We'll assign auto commanders. A great melee is being held, and unfortunately, we must never fight in a melee because Eddard Stark never did. He never fought in a melee. He didn't like to play at war, and he doesn't want people to know what he can do in a fight. So we will never fight in a melee, which also works for me because I don't like melees. I also don't like jousting. Whoa. What is this? Ah, Joffrey wants us to be a commander. You are no king of mine, boy. You are no king of mine. Let's get auto-stop plots on. Demand installation of claimant. Supported claimant is Lord Paramount Eddard. Supported claimant is backing the faction. Supported claimant does not have the same liege. All right. So we actually need to get Stannis in this as well, because Stannis right now doesn't think he should even get the Iron Throne, which is kind of funny. Stannis, I'm supporting you. Form an alliance? No. Can we give you money? Could we give you money? We could, but we really need our war chest. We need our war chest. Damn it. Whoa. Age 43, your acquaintance, Lord Krosnys of Slaver's Road, was murdered on the orders of Queen Daenerys of Astapor, has usurped the title Lordship of Astapor. Oh, shit. Daenerys has taken Astapor. Nice. Good for her. She will make, hopefully she will make a good queen in the future. What is this fool doing? We can't plot to kill him. That bastard. Somebody suggested marrying Edric Storm. I don't know about that. What about Gendry? I tried to figure out last time who Gendry was. Let's see. I thought Gendry and Edric Storm were the same person. Courtier in Harrenhal. Gendry the Bull. He is strong and giant. Fuck yes. Those are my kind of traits. And you are Joanna. Who is Joanna? Let's see. Landless. Well, what does it say for lands? This character does not rule nor live under any government. All right. And you are in a republic somehow. Gendry the Bull, you are indeed of good stock. But unfortunately, we've married everyone we can. Let's see. Sansa is betrothed to Renly. All right. Arya is betrothed to Lord Paramount Robert, or Sweet Robin of the Vale. Brandon is betrothed to Shireen Baratheon. And Rickon is still available. You know what we could do? We could forward Lord Hostertully to join our faction here to put Stannis on the throne. Surely we can do that. Ask to join factions. Let's see. And did that work? Yes! Mwah! Stannis hates his liege, so we now have the support of Stannis and the Riverlands. We can actually ask to... Yes, we can demand installation of the claimant now. Mwah! Things come together excellently. We need more favors. We need people to like us. We need Mace Tyrell. So as it stands right now, we have got 74% of the realm support. We've got Stannis. Well, Stannis doesn't have that many men. But we've got the Riverlands, and we have the North. All that will fight for Stannis' claim. The people who would probably be fighting us would be the Lannisters. Tywin Lannister. It'd be great if he were dead. I don't think Eddard himself would want to see Tywin dead. Someone pointed this out. Someone said that they think Tywin and Tyrion may be considered somewhat innocent. Actually, probably not Tywin, because Tywin gave the orders to have to have King's Landing sacked and the royal family butchered by Ser Clegane. So I don't think Tywin would really be... I think Tywin would actually... He would more or less stand trial for doing that. I think Tyrion would generally be considered innocent, but I think Cersei and Jaime would be... considered guilty. But yes, the Lannisters would definitely be fighting against us. Do they have allies? No, but they do have non-aggression packs. Who's the Reach allied with? No one. No one yet. But soon. Soon. Soon we shall have them. I mean, we've got enough people right now. Is 74% enough? I'm not sure. 61,000 men. I would like more. The more we can get, the better. Lower crown authority. Our power is waning, in a sense. Who else can we get on our side? Rickard Umber seeks to kill Lord Lambard. We need our monies, because if we're going to war, we need to be able to fund the war effort. I'd love to give my guys some new missions. So, for example, Lord Wyman, Lord Lamprey. Yeah, this guy was awesome. You saved us, sir. Grant land a title. I could, but that wouldn't really work. I will need to remember to reward Lord Lamprey for saving Eddard Stark. Let's see, she died natural death. Lord Lyman, let's see. Vassal discouraged from joining factions. Noble encouraged to join your faction. Oh, yes. What are the chances that that'll work? Almost 50%. Lord Lamprey, you boss. Okay, so what we could do is we could send him to scheme in Highgarden, and in a perfect world, we could convince Mace to support Stannis' claim on the Iron Throne, which would put us over the top. We would have more than enough to crush the Lannisters and put Stannis on the Iron Throne. But I'm thinking, if we're already swaying Mace Tyrell, there is the chance that he may just join us as he likes Eddard Stark more and more, or we could even... There's even events when it comes to swaying where we could convince him to give us a favor, in which case we can call him in to join our faction. And then, so what I'm trying to say is that maybe while we're swaying Mace Tyrell, maybe we have Lord Wyman instead scheme somewhere else. Like, it's very interesting that I can scheme in all the capitals of the most capitals of Westeros. It's kind of strange. But we can have him scheme for instance, in Storm's End. And so while we're swaying Mace Tyrell to join our faction, we could at the same time scheme to have Lord Wyman convince Renly to seat his brother as well. Or even the Martells of Dorne. Ooh. Mmm, damn, that's tempting. How many men does Renly have? 21,000. Mace Tyrell has 36,000. The Lannisters have 26,000. Hoster Tully has 27,000. Here's the thing, though. Here's the problem. If Hoster Tully dies, our alliance with the Riverlands ends as well. And Edmure Tully will take over the Riverlands. And he's married to the Lannisters, so he will join them. Because his wife is a Lannister. Why he accepted that marriage is beyond me. That's ridiculous. Shit. That is kind of a problem. Cannot invite to court. Opinion of Lord. He likes his. Yeah. Crap, that's not good. Let's see. Apparently, Lord Lucifer wants Queen Daenerys on the throne. Speaking of Daenerys, is she still widowed? She's not. Oh, snap. Would she accept a betrothal? No! Is too young. But she will do it if it's matrilinear. God damn, this is a quandary. This is a quandary because she has dragons. She has the potential for greatness. However, I'm conflicted about it because I have read that support from Daenerys Targaryen when she's over here in Slaver's Bay is not that good. She would be sending men to us in small amounts, and it would take a long time for them all to get here. So in an actual war, she wouldn't be that good. Also, she is not willing. She's not willing to let House Targaryen die. So if we did betroth Lord Rickon to her, I don't know how they would have children. I know Eddard Stark would have no problem with Daenerys because I think he understands, you know, because when Robert was calling for Daenerys to be killed or assassinated, it was Eddard Stark who was saying, you know what, no, we don't need to do this. But I'm not seeing Rickon marrying Daenerys being that useful for us. In fact, I almost, and I mean, we're currently trying to put Stannis on the throne. I think that's a conflict of interest. Because it's like, we're trying to get Stannis on the throne because he's a lord here that's close by who actually... But then again, I guess Eddard could say that Queen Daenerys technically has the, actually has more of a claim than Stannis does. But Daenerys' family was deposed because they were considered tyrannical. And if we don't marry her now, someone else might. And she may very well still conquer all of Slaver's Bay and still come to Westeros. Because, you know, it's not often the AI does that, but it is possible. Damn, that is... What a quandary. But it would be kind of a Littlefinger moment, would it not? Because if she does come to Westeros and she is betrothed to Rickon Stark... If, for whatever reason, our push to get Stannis on the Iron Throne fails, we always have Daenerys as a backup plan. However, if both of these plans come to fruition, they will conflict with each other. You know what? It's so rare to get the chance to be able to actually marry Daenerys that I think we're going to go for it. We're going to go for it, and we're going to get her betrothed to Rickon, and we are going to have it be a matrilineal marriage. That means that whatever children they have will be Targaryens, but they will also be of Stark blood. And consider it like an insurance plan. In case Stannis dies, we can always put Daenerys on the throne, because she has a right of way there as well. Now, if Stannis finds out that we're supporting Daenerys as well, he will not be happy. She might even disagree. She might even say, no, I decline. She might. I don't know. Oh, fuck. We got to do something with Lyman, don't we? Okay. Okay, because we don't have much of the way of time, I'm going to put more of a focus on Highgarden. We need to get Mace Tyrell on board. We need to get him to pledge his forces to our cause to get Stannis on the throne. And we need to do it before Lord Paramount Hoster dies. He's not sick or anything. Unfunny church. All right. While passing judgment on criminals from the safety of your throne, a young noble is brought before you. You quickly come to the conclusion that the man is indeed guilty. Condemning him might not be the wisest choice, as he is of noble birth. If you were to pardon the man, he might prove himself useful to you, as he would be in your debt. Release him. Do not forget what I have done for you. A courtier named Devon. Being of noble birth means nothing to the dungeons with you. Agreed. Agreed! All right, so we're redoubling our... To the proud noble Eddard... Blessings upon you and your house. Why is she pissed off with us? Usurped title. I didn't take your titles. Well, maybe she thinks I did. What a bitch. I have decided to accept your suggestion of a matrilineal betrothal between Lord Lyricon and Queen Daenerys. Ah, here we go. My lord, I have changed my mind about the proposed marriage between Lyricon and myself. This is because I rule the kingdom of Astapor in my own right, and as such, I want my heirs to continue the line of House Targaryen. Well, they would have continued them anyways, only... See, so she disagreed. Instead, she wanted to marry King Orgaz. Right. So I think she's got plans to stay in Slaver's Bay. Her choice. Her choice. Anyways. Let's see if we can't use Rickon now to further the line. Tully's. She's widowed. Is her lover Peter Baelish? It is. Ah. Peter Baelish! Will you join my court? No, you are the Lord of Midler Point. You will not join our court. All right. Unfortunate. Garland Tyrell. Where are you, sir? Garland the Gallant. Ooh. Imprisoned by King Joffrey of the Iron Throne. Will you come to my court? No. He likes his father more. Can't fault him for that. Marjorie is now in Children's Tower, Moat Cailin. Yeah, so Marjorie is in Moat Cailin with her husband, Lord Robb. Excellent. Renly, do you have any sisters? No. Shireen is betrothed to us as well. Rickon, can they have no more daughters? No. We could maybe Arianne. Ooh, actually, you know what? She might not agree. We could have also married Lord Robb to Lady Arianne. Maybe she would accept a betrothal between Rickon. No, he's too young. I'm wondering if we couldn't do matrilinear marriage. Let's see. Prince Doran. Getting Doran on our side would also help our cause. Do you have anyone that would be willing to marry Rickon? Preferably one that isn't a bastard. Well, Arianne, but we'd have to do matrilinear. How old is Rickon? He's 4. God, they've got a lot of bastards. I mean, Arianne will accept. She will accept, but it will be matrilinear. But it would build an alliance with House Martell, or it could. Does he like us? He doesn't hate us. And plus, that would mean that Doran would have a reason to ally with us. And when he passes, Lady Arianne would still be on our side as well, because she stands to inherit Dorne, and she'd be betrothed to Rickon as matrilinear. And then when Rickon comes of age, we could always just break that alliance or break that betrothal, which is kind of underhanded. And actually, that would be too underhanded for Eddard Stark. I don't think that would work. But let's take one for the team and suggest a betrothal between Arianne Martell and Rickon. Yes, I mean, he doesn't come of age for like 12 years or something, which means that she'll be in her 40s, 4, 5, 6, 7. She'll be 37. I've already done it. It's too late now. And we're doing it to support Stannis' claim. To the most excellent Paramount Eddard, Lord Paramount Eddard, I've decided to accept. Good. I'm glad you have accepted. No, I have changed my mind. This is because by Salt Dornish custom, female members of my house may inherit titles and such. I want the bride to continue the line of House Martell. Yeah, she will. Alright, fine by me. Dorne wants to do their own fucking thing. They will regret this. Actually, they probably won't. It was actually pretty damn clever on their part. We could marry Princess Marcella to Rickon, but I think that would lead to a non-aggression pact, and I don't want to be a pact breaker. We don't want that. Harold Arryn has a child, Elise Stone. Yeah, but she's a bastard too. We could maybe... Nope, she's already married. Damn it. Lady Asha, the Kraken's daughter, has married Carl the Maid. Damn. Nice. So I don't really see anybody for Rickon to be able to marry. I don't see it happening. No, you have no daughters. Does Edmure have a daughter? No. Lysa, Catelyn, nope. No, there's... I don't see... I mean, we could marry somebody... No, there's no one else we can marry Rickon to. That would be useful for us. Unless... Yeah, but I don't want to be a betrothal breaker. That's not what Eddard would do. Eddard wouldn't do that. He's too honorable to be a betrothal breaker. Lord Paramount Mace's men have outdated drilling routines, and it is almost embarrassing to see them in action. I could send him some books or maybe some commanders to help him get his men up to date. Is that because he's a poor military ruler? Yes. A commander would get those soldiers up in no time, up to scratch in no time. A chance to help improve Lord Paramount Mace's understanding of warfare and sway him to my cause. Maybe I am overstepping my boundaries here. No! Send a commander at once. We must aid our brother, Lord Paramount Mace of the Reach. Hosting a grand hunt. Good for him. We must get Lord Paramount Mace on our side. Oh, what? Oh, he was disfigured in a hunt. Oh, that sucks. It's a shame we didn't marry somebody to Lord Wylys. No, House Yelshire. I mean, she's not a bad-looking wife. Not a bad one, but I would have preferred having in a... Why does he have green eyes? Oh, so green eyes is a trait of House Tyrell. That's very fucking cool. I like that. Ooh, wow, Marjorie's pregnant already. She's not cheating on Rob, is she? No, doesn't seem like she is. Queen Daenerys Stormborn has inherited City of Plaza of Pride. Good for her. She has decided to do her own thing, so she is no longer someone of interest to us. And we are swaying Mace Tyrell. However, whoa, what is happening? Defending against Lord Paramount Baelon, to decrease crown authority. Okay. And who does Baelon have on his side? Ooh, I want to see. Who is aiding you? Okay, the attackers. Lord Paramount... Oh my god. Lord Paramount Baelon II is attacking the Iron Throne to lower crown authority. It is Lord Paramount Baelon of the Iron Isles, Lord Paramount Hoster of the Trident, and Lord Paramount Tywin of the Westerlands. Yes, it is my duty to defend my liege. I will not concern myself for now. The rebel's cause is just. We'll join Lord Paramount Baelon. Now is the time to break free. I mean, if I were Rob, yes. Yes, I would. But I don't think Eddard's really interested in having the North to be free. I think he wants to see Stannis on the throne. And wants to see King Joffrey's authority lowered. Sir Jacelyn Ironhand. Right. I think the rebel's cause is just. We will lower crown authority with the Westerlands and the Riverlands. Because, I mean, there's nothing else we can really do other than trying to become independent. Which, I mean, doesn't really help us. It doesn't really help us. I think we will aid the Ironborn. Or maybe we can just not do anything. God, I don't know. I don't know what I want to do. Do we want to fight? Because I would love to see King Joffrey weakened. Wait, if we can capture King Joffrey and get him in our dungeons. No, we can't. We can't force our demands because our faction has been paralyzed. Well, it would be the opportunity we would need to... Well, I mean, his forces are already going to be weakened. He's got 12,000. And his forces are already going to be weakened by the Trident, the Westerlands, and the Iron Isles. Maybe it would be wiser to simply stay out of this, focus on building support with the Reach and everyone else, and then going back and trying to put Stannis on the throne, assuming Joffrey even survives the war. We will not concern ourselves with this for now. The Westerlands, we will let the Lannisters destroy each other and the Ironborn. Hopefully the Riverlanders don't lose too many men, and we will focus on trying to get the Reach on our side. However, the Riverlands are in a very precarious position because, like I said, Edmure Tully is married to Cersei Lannister, which is very bad. There's been a lot of chaos at Lord Paramount Mace's court recently. My courtier suddenly approached me with a letter today where the ungrateful bastard blames me for the recent chaos. What a disgrace. Ooh, that's not good. How dare you, sir? Confused by warfare. Well, I mean, a little gift could see that undone. But he might not even survive, because he's disfigured and severely injured. Okay, don't really care about that. We will continue our attempts to sway Mace Tyrell. We will build up our treasury. We've got our spymaster. Has transferred the vassal contract. Alright. Mace Tyrell might take a very bad... He might take a turn for the worst here. That's assuming he even lives. I'm wondering if maybe we shouldn't try to sway... I mean, Lord Wyllys already likes us, so that's good. And when can we change our focus? Not for a long time. Damn. House Martell has no interest in allying with us. We are betrothed to Renly, and I'd love to, make him like us more, because he actually does have a good opinion of us. Arranged betrothal, medium realm authority. You don't like us because we have medium realm authority? Sweet Robin of the Vale is still sickly, so he might not survive either. What quality of education would you purchase for your courtier Tomard? I don't know who that is. So nothing. Who is Idol? Wyman Manderly. Ooh, right. We don't have any factions at the moment, so we can't convince him to like us. I'm wondering if we shouldn't have him... Maybe we should wait till the war's over and just have him... Plot uncovered. Vassal discouraged from joining factions. Build a spy network. Vicious rumors spread. But we wouldn't be able to change that for quite some time. But the war could last for quite some time as well. Damn, I don't know what to do. Let's not have him do anything. We'll have Lord Wyman just kind of dick around for now. I just want him to be available to jump on scheming the moment the war is over. Let's see. Ah, yes. Lord, is there anyone really powerful supporting King Joffrey? No. Nope. Raiders under Lord Gerald the Great of Wick have arrived to loot and pillage in Lord Paramount Mace of the Reach's County of the Arbor, of course. Arbor's down here. It's a fantastic place to raid. Aegon Targaryen invades. A young silver-haired man has landed in Westeros, claiming to be Aegon, two-born son of Rhaegar Targaryen and rightful king of the Seven Kingdoms. It is widely believed that he perished in the Red Keep at the hands of Sir Gregor Clegane during the War of the Usurper, along with his sister Rhaenys and mother Aelia of Dorne. It is purported that it was not Aegon who perished there, but some peasant baby who was put in Aegon's place, which is reasonable. Now this claimant lands, except where would they get the peasant baby? Kind of odd. Now this claimant lands, and he has the Golden Company at his back. Long live the true king. Aegon is dead. He is a mummer's dragon. And he's going to land somewhere here in the Stormlands. So the Stormlands are going to be... they're going to be turned upside down, essentially, because Aegon's going to land here. Let's see. Defending against... Oh. Okay. So, Westeros is broken up into major civil war now. The Iron Isles, the Trident, and the Westerlands are all attacking the crown, which is kind of strange that Lord Tywin is attacking his own, what, grandson? Yes. The defenders of Joffrey is Lord Paramount Robert of the Vale, Lord Mace of the Reach, and Lord Renly of the Stormlands, and now Aegon is attacking. A bunch of craziness is happening, and Eddard must be very careful with where he goes from here. Does he support the supposed last son of Rhaegar Targaryen, Aegon, or does he continue trying to get Stannis on the throne? Or does he try to go for northern independence? There's so many different things that we need to try. And since this is such a big event, you know, Westeros is already in the midst of a civil war. And now Aegon Targaryen invades. What will Eddard Stark do? I will let you all in the comments section tell me which direction Eddard Stark should go. and we will decide going there, but all that will have to take place in the next episode. Thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe as always. This has been Crusader Kings 2, The Wolf's Revenge. I have been the Golden Joeblivion, and until next time, I will see you all later.